Hey guys, we are going to do, because the All-Star break is started, the three-point contest and everything is today and the All-Star game is tomorrow, we're going to see what would happen if the playoffs started at the All-Star break. So, let's just jump right into it. So, please like and subscribe and get some popcorn and enjoy. Now we have the Celtics up 3-1, up by 3 points with 30 seconds to go. It is Magic Ball. Banchero has it. 1 point game. Timeout Celtics. Okay. 29.1 to go. Brown passes it into Tatum. Tatum dribbles. Spins. Tatum behind the 3 point line. What's he gonna do? He's dribbling at the clock. Rise, pulls up, mini, it's good. 3 point game with 11.2 to go. Shot clock is off. Magic calling their last timeout. There's no timeouts remaining for either team. Both teams are in the bonus. Passes it into Banchero. Banchero, they need a three. Passes it out. Fultz for three. He missed it. Rebound Tatum. And he gets away from the Magic. 1.2 to go. Tatum's going to shoot free throws. If he makes one of these, the Celtics are moving on to the second round. This is our first team moving on. Literally every game is in a 3-2 except for this one. Ridiculous. No teams can seem to close out series. But the Celtics are going to do it here because Tatum has nailed both free throws. So the Magic is 1.2 to go. They don't have any time to do anything. Puts up a shot at the buzzer. It's no good. Celtics are moving on to the second round. Down go the 18 Magic. And down go the Celtics. 3-1. And they are looking like they're up 6 with 33 to go. It looks like the 8 seed has been upset the 1 seed, like what happened last year in the East. Okay, this is surprising. Wow. I don't know if the Timberwolves can connect or the 1 seed for a reason. Right, guys, maybe they can get out of this hole, but I doubt it. Especially with having a foul. Maybe Edwards can shoot a three, he doesn't. He just misses that. Although Reed gets the rebound, puts it back up. It's still not good. That's the game. They're not even a foul at this point. It's Barnes on the wing. Fox hits three. This game is so over. Oh my god. Well, Sacramento just swept the onesies, so. I mean, not swept. Took out the onesie. And rebound Murray. So Fox is just going to dribble this clock out. Probably the biggest upset we'll see all video, considering the onesie Celtics just won in the first round. So. The onesie goes out, and on goes the 8 seed to the next round. Very surprising, but De'Aaron Fox absolutely carrying. He's ridiculously good. His vertical is like absolutely ridiculous. But I'll see you guys in the next game. And yeah. One seed goes out. The 5 seed. No, the Suns are the 4. No, the Nuggets are the 4 seed. The Suns are the 5 seed. So yeah, we do have an upset. The 5 seed over the 4 seed. The Suns absolutely crushed them in game 6. Yeah, in game 6. And yeah, so rebound, Booker's in the middle of clock out. So down go the Nuggets, last year's champs. And the Suns looking very promising going into round 2-6. We have Cleveland up 3-2. Oh, Rozier drives and he scores. But they are down 4 with 10 seconds left to go. So I don't know. This is probably going to go to a game 7. unless Cleveland hits a 3. And then something like. Even if they hit a 3 and then Miami, okay, so they hit the 3, so now even if Miami makes both free throws, it's still a 3-point game, so Cleveland is in. Hero's shooting, he's probably not going to make. So let's see what happens, 7.4 to go. No timeouts left for Cleveland, the Cavs are not going to be able to advance the ball. They're going to have to foul again, they're not shooting yet. Who's going to be shooting for girls? It's going to be Terry Rozier. So Terry Rozier shooting it. He makes the first. It's a 2-point game. Can he make it a 3-point game? This will be huge. Rozier makes the second. 6.8 to go. They're going to have to get it up the court quick. I pass it to Mitchell. Oh, no, they pass it to Okoro. He's not a free shooter, but he makes it. So now we're going to overtime unless Butler makes this. Yeah, we're going to overtime. So Cleveland is actually able to hold on. I'm really surprised that he made that three at the end. That's crazy. Cleveland is going to overtime, and they're going to try and upset. I mean, not upset. They're the two seed. They're going to try and beat. Now in overtime, Cleveland is up by 4 points. Trying to close out this series in six games. It is their ball. Mitchell shoots it. It's good. They're up by six. It's looking pretty grim for the Heat here. And they're going to call a timeout with 46 seconds to go. Rozier shoots it. It's no good. Rebound. Mobley passing it over to Mitchell. They're going to foul him. They had a foul again. Passing it in to Mitchell. Oh, no, not Mitchell. Allen. Oh, Allen was fouled. He almost got to the basket. Oh, Bam just fouled out. That's absolutely huge for Cleveland. And Allen's going to make the first free throw. I just hit it. It's over. Oh, he missed. Butler has it. 7-point game.
Diversified scoring in this one for him. I love when everyone can get involved. A full team effort.
Oh, 2 points there. So now, 5-point game. Cleveland passing it in. Find the bucket. In the Garland's foul. Rozier has 3 fouls. Now it's 5-point game with 21 to go. Garland, first free throw. Good. This is looking really bad. Next free throw, no good. Caleb Martin gets it. He called their final timeout.
Not to like how dynamic Garland is on the floor. He's a high energy player. It's hard to maximize his impact. Now a timeout called by Miami. They trail by six.
He'd have the ball. Down six.
And looking for a very
and Rozier, they need a three. Why is he driving? He misses it, and that's the game. I don't even know if they're going to foul. They are going to foul. It's a 6-point game. Fourth foul on Rozier. 14 seconds left in overtime. Cleveland's going to win this series. Two seed is going to beat the 7th seed in 6 games. Cleveland is going to win on the road. So they're going to the second round. The Heat are going to go out, unlike last year where they were the 7th seed and they went all the way to the final. I mean, the 8th seed, they went all the way to the final. So this year, they're the 7th seed, and they're going out.
And that makes it a 7-point lead.
First free throw for Garland is good. Second one is about to happen. Second free throw is also good. This game is over. Yeah.
And they've been a different team here in overtime.
Now that
shoots
to the eyes.
Seem to have lost their energy.
Oh my gosh. Why am I saying you want a huge surprise? You're not a surprise at all. You're expecting. I don't even know why they're fouling. This game's over. Caleb Martin picks up the foul. Send Mitchell to the line.
Donovan Mitchell.
Mitchell, first free throw is good. Second free throw. It's also good.
Especially on the offensive end.
Hero has the ball. He's going to run up the clock. Actually, he's going to pass to Martin, who's going to shoot a three. No good. Buzzer expired. So down goes the Heat, and to the second round is the 2-seed Cleveland. Up by 8 points on the 2-seed. They're going to try and upset them. They're probably going to upset them. Shea missing this final game. I don't know what from, because injuries are off in this simulation. So I don't know what happened to Shea. Maybe, like, I don't know, maybe what treatment or something, but I don't think that can happen in these. But I have no idea where Shea is. He's not in the game. I literally tried switching to the Thunder and tried putting him in, but he wasn't there. So yeah, that's... I was simmed last game, and I noticed Shea was in. So I don't know what happened to this game. But yeah, Luka's just going to dribble this out, and... Mavericks, who are the 17th, are going to the second round. Oh, he's going to get posterizing dunk. Shot clock is off. 9 seconds to go. I don't even know if the Thunder are going to shoot this. They probably are. Yeah, definitely putting a stamp on this. Three is good, but it doesn't matter. It's over. It's a 7.8. Luka's going to dribble out the clock. 3, 2, 1. And that's the game. The Mavericks are moving on, which I don't think many people were expecting. To be honest, I always have faith in the Mavericks. I think Luka is like the MVP of the league. He's so good. He's just amazing. So I'm not surprised. I think a lot of you will be, but we'll see him. And we're going to go to the next game. Between the Bucks and the Pacers. The Bucks and the Pacers. Oh, Dane gets a steal. Dane drives. He goes up for it. What up? Oh, he gets fouled, but no, the shot doesn't go. So that's it, too. First free throw is good. See if he gets the second. He does, and the Bucks are up two. Damian Lillard has had an incredible game. He's scored, I think, almost 70 points. He's had his career high. I saw, when I was swimming, I saw some pop-up about Dame breaking the scoring record for a playoff game. And I was like, oh, let me check it out. So I jumped in 5 minutes early, and I've been watching this game ever since. But this is an absolutely close game. This is an amazing game. And now it's tied again with 14 seconds to go. If Dame hits the buzzer beater, that's a perfect ending to his career high. Like, that would be absolutely crazy. Oh my gosh, this is a very intense game. And Giannis has a takeover badge. What's Giannis? No, get it to Dame, please. Giannis dies. Oh, out to Dame. Dame, wide open for three. He missed it. And it's going to overtime. Dame missed the wide open buzzer. Dame, you have to have hit that. You've been hitting those all game. You have like 12 threes or something. How did you miss that? No, that's so sad. Oh, that would have been perfect. See, that was one of Dame's threes. He's absolutely having an incredible game. So I'll see you with around a minute 30 left in overtime. 1 point here with a minute 30 left in overtime. A minute 20 now. Giannis drives. He scores. It's a 3-point game. Bucks are winning by three. Halliburton has the ball. Back to Siakam. Siakam for three. He missed it. Rebound Dame. Dame dribbles it up the court. Dame, he has it. Oh, he crosses over on Halliburton. He goes up for the shot. The mini. It's no good, surprisingly. And now, whoever that is, I can't pronounce his name. I'm sorry. I don't want to botch it. So now Halliburton has it. Oh, he passes out to whoever that is, and he misses the three. I'm not pronouncing his name, okay? Middleton drives. Over to Beasley. Beasley swings it to Giannis. Giannis up over the 5-point game with 30 seconds to go. Oh, the Bucks are going to complete a crazy win in game seven. Halliburton has the ball. Oh, he gets a wide open look and he dunks it in. 3-point game, 32 seconds to go. Bucks ball. Lopez passes it in. Good game. Dame passes it to Giannis. Giannis drives on Siakam. Siakam defending. Giannis trying to find a way in the paint. Giannis drives. Over Siakam. He got it. It's a 5-point game again with 18 seconds to go. Shot clock is off. This is a crazy game, folks. Whoever that is passes it into whoever that is passes it to Halliburton. Halliburton, mini, no good. Bucks ball, they're gonna foul, and the Bucks are gonna move on. I mean, they should be moving on. There's 11 seconds to go. They're up 5 with the ball. So the Bucks and Dame are actually gonna move on. It's crazy because Dame's had such a good game. So fouling out is Halliburton. This game is 100% over now that Halliburton's is out. No one on their team can hit a three now. I mean, I guess Miles Turner can shoot. But nothing from that. So now out is Halliburton. Over to Siakam. Siakam for three. It's good. So it's a 4-point game, 3 seconds to go. They're going to pass it to Giannis. They're not going to foul Giannis. The Bucks are moving on to the second round. An absolute thriller in overtime. in game seven versus Indiana. So they're going to go to the second round. An absolute thriller, and I'll see you guys in the next matchup. Wait, actually, never mind. I have to show you. Dame scored 76. Yeah, Dame scored 76. We're up 3-0 on the Knicks. They're finally going to put the Knicks away in seven. The Knicks almost had the first ever 3-0 comeback win to win in game seven. They just can't complete it. Philadelphia outscoring them 152-123 in game seven, and that's the game. So down go New York into the second round of Maxi. We have one last game seven in this round, and then we're going to round. Somehow got to game seven, and I'm winning by 1 point. In game seven, it is the Clippers' ball. Kawhi has it. Kawhi's gonna go up with it on Zion. He's gonna miss. Now it's 1:15 to go. Pelicans with the ball up one. Jones. Zion completely wide. He's gonna lay that up and in. It's a 3-point game. Somehow the Clippers probably might lose here. Pelicans. Zion. And a little bit of Jonas Valanciunas and Zion Ingram. I mean, Randy is okay. Three, no good. Rebound, Pelicans. Pelicans up 3:48 to go. Over to Jones. Jones driving. Jones puts that up. No good. Rebound, Kawhi. 40 seconds to go. Kawhi's trying to get around. Kawhi drives. And he's fouled. It's a shooting foul, so Kawhi will go to the line. Or two free throws. First free throw is good. Second free throw is good. It's a 1-point game with 30 seconds to go. Ingram puts up a lay. It's good. It's a 3-point game again with 26 seconds to go. 2.3 separating the shot clock. What? Most three-pointers made in a playoff game record by CJ McCollum. What? Bro, let me see how many points he has. He has 29 points. How does he have the record for most points in a playoff game for the Pelicans and most threes? That's not even possible. Like, just before when I was watching it, like a minute 30 left, he scored a three and then he had the most points ever in Pelicans playoffs. Like, have the Pelicans never been in the playoffs? That's a good point. Pelicans are almost never in the playoffs, so I guess that makes a bit more sense. But still, like 29, that's crazy. So now it's the Clippers' ball. They're down three. PJ Tucker's gonna pass it into Kawhi Leonard, and they're gonna call a timeout. Why are they calling another timeout? Now PJ Tucker is gonna have to pass it to Harden. Harden with the ball. Harden dribbles into Kawhi. Kawhi drives, puts up the one-hand floater. It's no good. Rebound, Valanciunas. They're going to foul him, and the Clippers are going. That's really surprising. The Clippers are actually going home in the first round versus the Pelicans. Wow. Well, Clippers fans, damn. I don't think anyone was expecting you guys to go out in the first round to the Pelicans. First shot is good. It's a 4-point game. I think this is over. Second is good. So it's a 5-point game. This game is over. Even if they make a three and then they make, and then the Pelicans make both free throws, it's still over. Leonard for three. He misses it. This game's over. Are they even going to foul? Yeah, they are. But there's only 4.9 to go. It's a 5-point game then. This game's over. So down go the Clippers. On go the Pelicans. I don't think anyone was expecting this, not even Pelicans fans. So, wow. Surprising. Harden is just going to shoot the buzzer. It's no good. And they're going to go down by 5 in game 7. And we're headed to the second round. And the Clippers are not in it, surprisingly. But there goes out in game 1 with the ball up to 26 seconds to go. Oh! And he's going to block it, but it's going to be the Bucks ball. Almost a steal there by Niang. Anacumbo passes in to Dame. Garland fouls Dame. Dame's on the line. He makes both of these. It's a 4-point game. That's bad. control of the Cavs. He makes the first, he makes the second. Yes, he is. Both on the other half, just losing the 3-4 chance. Donovan Mitchell is, I don't know where he is. Same thing that happened to Shai. I don't know where he is. He's not here. He tried coming in. He's in the game with Shai. He wasn't there. So I don't know what happened. My star players are just disappointing. Okoro. It's a really deep, but he hits it. Wow. Really deep three by Okoro trying to stay in this, and he makes it. So now they're going to pass it in. He uses his power. He makes both these. It's only a 3-point game, but LeVert fouls out. First free throw for Beasley is good. It's a 2-point game. Can he make it a 3-point game? Shot clock is off. Beasley's second free throw is good. It's a 3-point game. Cast full timeout. So last timeout. Bucks have one more. 16-1, shoot it up. Can the Cavs take a 3-point game? I personally have passed it to Okoro. Because he's been hitting threes left and right in these series. Oh, what was Garland? No, that's not what they need, but he's going to hit it. So now they're going to try and shoot two more free throws. And they foul Beasley. Well, I don't know about that. Beasley makes both these. It's still a 3-point game. So it's a 2-point game now. Beasley's going to make the next one. He ends with a 3-point game, 11-point shot to go for the Cavs. Going to do this time. Pass it to Garland. Garland's going to go it up. Give it to Okoro. Here's a Merrill. Garland's Yang. Yang for three. He hit it. He hit it with 3-1, 3 to go. He hit the three. Yang, game-saving three there. 3.3 seconds to go. Bucks ball, tie game. Are the Bucks going to walk this series off on a buzzer? Who are they going to pass it into? I'm assuming Dame, because he's the buzzer-beater king. They give it to Dame. 2-1. Oh, Beasley, layup, it's good. It's good, and the Bucks win this yet. Well, it's not yet. He didn't get a shot off. He gained it, but he didn't get it off in time, and the Bucks win the series. Wow, that's crazy. He made the shot, but he didn't get it off in time. Beasley with the winning layup, and the Bucks are going to move on. That was crazy. That was ridiculous. And Garland made the full quarter. Didn't count because he didn't get it off in time. Oh my God, they would have won this. They would have won the game and sent it to game five, but he didn't get it off in time. Wow, I'll see you in the next one. The Mavs, so they're going to kind of meet up seat. Upset the Pelicans, even though I don't think it's really an... Oh my God, Doncic is crazy. I mean, he's really upset because it's a 7 versus a 16, and the Mavericks are clearly better as they showed in the series winning in 6 games. So they're going to go to the conference finals, and down to the Pelicans, who shouldn't even be here, but yeah, Lucas scores 41, showing why he's the MVP. Well, he should be the MVP, but yeah. So basically... The Pelicans are out, and the Mavericks are moving on. Thriller for you guys. The Celtics are up 3-2, up 4. 1 minute 30 to go. But it's the 76ers ball. Okay, so Embiid didn't disappear like a bunch of the other stars did. Wait, but where's Brown? Wait, did Brown disappear? Wait, Brown disappeared. Why Xavier Tillman? Okay, I guess Brown disappeared too. What the heck? Where's Tyrese Collins right there? Okay, well, Celtics up 2 with 1:10 to go. We're probably going to lose just because Brown's not here, but I don't know where he is. Wide open 3, he misses. Wait, actually, real quick, I want to see if Brown is in this game. Call timeout for the Celtics. Probably needed that. We need to see, is Brown here? Yeah, he's right there. Why is Brown not in this game? No, let's just go to starter. Yeah, that's how it's supposed to be. Okay. Yeah, okay, so let's just go back to this. And yeah, so now, oh shoot, I can't do that. I'm sorry, guys. My fault. No, this must be a reason. What am I doing? Okay, now Brown is not gone, which I thought he was. So now Tatum kind of fall. Celtics are up two. Matthew's crying. Porzingis is up over Embiid, and he's going to score now. He's going to have time out 50 seconds to go. 4 point game. Sorry for that little messed up earlier when I tried to get Brown in. Okay, so Aubrey Jr. is going to pass it into Maxey. Maxey gets a screen. He doesn't use it. Passes to Embiid. Embiid drives on Porzingis. Embiid puts up the floater. He looks like LeBron James, except for he missed, unlike LeBron James. Pass over to Holiday. Holiday spins. He's fouled. 32 seconds left to go. Maxey's one foul away from fouling out. Holiday, first free throw. That's good. It's a 5-point game. Not looking good for the Sixers here. Second free throw is good. Harris passes it to Max. Max dribbles down the court though. Oh, they're gonna call timeout. No timeouts left for either team. Celtics are in the bonus. No, not to Maxey. Into Heal. Oh, it's stolen by Brown. That's the game. Oubre fouled out. He had 10 points. Tatum first free throw is good. Yeah, this game's over. The 76ers actually put up a fight. They sent it to six games, which I wouldn't expect it. Considering how good the Celtics are. But in the end, Celtics just overwhelmed them. Maxey to Harris. Harris for three. Harris misses three. Matt White, rock and foul. White, I mean, Holiday will just dribble out the clock with 10 seconds to go.
Holiday against Maxey. Holiday surveying.
3, 2, 1. Happy New Year! So the Celtics are moving on and down to the second in between the Kings and the Suns. Suns up 2 with a minute left. Oh, Sabonis, he's fouled! The shot's no good. Bonus shoots it, he makes the first free throw. Okay. Is he gonna have a game? He has 31 points tonight, now 32. Wow. So Nurkic, he's gonna pass it in to Booker. It's a tie game with a minute 10 to go.
Booker against Fox.
Booker. Oh, pass over to KD, wide open for three. What? How did he just miss that? KD, what are you doing? You're wide open from three, and now Fox is going to score. Bro, and now you're losing. That angers me so much. How? KD, who was one of the best three-point shooters of all time. It's so easy to hit three when you're shooting. Bro. It's just ridiculous. Why are you calling it on the top? The Suns are just making me mad right now. Considering they've had a huge comeback, they were down like 30 at halftime. I don't know how they did it.
There's 47 Booker. Seconds left in the game.
If he misses, like, Beal back to Booker. Booker spinning. Oh, that was sick. Booker, he missed. Booker can't get it to he go. Fucking missed. Are you fucking kidding me? What a monk. Monk, of course, he's gonna dunk the shit in. Oh, I'm sorry. Oh my god. We're up. The Suns did all this just to lose now. The Suns are gonna call their last time. What? Why don't you just call it before you inbound the ball and waste 3 precious seconds? Oh my god, the Suns' logic makes me want to scream. Like, get a wide open 3. You need a 3. You need a 3. 3-pointer. No, what is... Okay, I guess it's good that they made it, but now they foul. It's going to be a 4-point game. Because I really doubt that Malik Monk is going to miss a free throw. And Bradley Beal's fouled. So Malik Monk misses a free throw. Never mind. So the Suns are actually in this game. Without Beal, but they're still in the game. They have to hit a 3 right here. They need it so bad. They need to just score, actually. Booker, come on. Get something going.
Pass to Gordon.
Gordon.
Now here's Allen.
Over to Allen. Allen for three. He got it. Time game. 1-1 to go. He got it. No more timeouts left for either team. Jordan. It's a tie game. Bro, that means that you're not going to foul. That means that you're involved. So if you did a couple videos ago, he's probably going to hit another freaking buzzer beater three. But, oh no. Oh, he's going to pass it. Monk! For the win, he got it.
When the defender isn't fighting over the screen,
the coach over there just asking for one simple thing, and that's some effort.
Monk, right in front of the three-point line, wide open. Well, why they left him wide? The buzzer sounds, and he hits it to win it in game seven. Oh my God! How are the Kings going from the 8th seed? How are you in the conference finals? I mean, I guess the Heat made it to the finals. They are going down to the Mavericks. If they beat the Mavericks, bro, I don't even know, because they just beat the Suns. How did they beat KD and Devo?
Thanking you for watching. Now our new
bro. We're gonna take down the Bucks in 6 games.
17 seconds left in the game.
Not close game most of the game, and then the Celtics pulled ahead in the fourth.
Here's Middleton.
Middleton makes it, but it's too late. 10-point game with 9 seconds to go. Jalen threw out the Celtics score in the finals. And they're playing either Sacramento or Dallas. Between the Dallas Mavericks and the Sacramento Kings, Dallas up one with the ball. Luka Doncic, absolutely crazy. He's so good. He's probably going to win the MVP this season, just for 12 weeks out. And Dallas is having a really good year. Oh, he's wide. Oh, my God. Rose it down. Luka with 48 today. Luka on Fox. Fox is fast as hell. Oh, he gets somebody fouled, so he's gonna go to the line, shoot two. 1:13 to go. It's a 3-point game. He misses the first free throw. Wow. De'Aaron Fox, second free throw up. He makes it. So it's a 2-point game. Mavericks ball. Luka Doncic winning. Drives. Out of the gap, back to Doncic. Doncic passes to Washington. Washington, what is it? 60 seconds. Luka, floater, off the backboard, no good. Rebound Fox. Fox passes it up to Barnes. Barnes, drives. Barnes, puts it up. He got it. Time game, 45 seconds to go. Mavericks call a timeout. It's a Luka. Kyrie's good too, that's great. Oh, up, and he's fouled, and it's been, oh, he almost made it. So now he's gonna have 2 free throws. First free throw, up, and good. Mavericks have a 1-point lead, 48.9 to go. Second free throw, good. 2-point lead for the Mavs. Kings call timeout. Fox. Kings call timeout. Just call one. But okay. You may spend timeout.
There's 38 seconds left in the game. Pass to Murray.
That's Murray. Fox for three. Miss. Washington rebound. 27 seconds to go. Over to Luka. Luka drives. Puts it up. No good. 19 seconds to go. Up on two is the Mavericks. Shot clock is off. Are the Kings going to walk this off on a free? Are they going to send it to overtime? Or are they going to lose? What's going to happen? Oh no. Fox still wide open. Looks for bonus. He made it. 5 seconds to go. Mavericks go timeout. They're going to advance the ball. Mavericks ball. 5 seconds to go. Tie game. You have to give it to Luka Doncic. Give it to Luka Doncic. Thank you. Doncic, one over three. He got it. Luka, it's the three. What 1.4 seconds to go. Timeout, Sacramento. They're going to advance the ball. It's a three-point game. The most they can do is send it to overtime. Who are they going to pass it into? Right here. 5-3. No, literally down to the Mavericks are going to the finals. Luka Doncic walk off three. Luka Doncic. That was crazy. Oh my God, Luka. De'Aaron Fox lost and he was wide open. Pretty deep out from three. And he hits it. Now it's Celtics Mavs in the finals. That three was amazing. Luka actually just spamming three. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Luka spam threes. Oh my gosh. Luka deserves this Western Conference Finals MVP. More than anyone. And I'll see you guys in the finals. 5 points in a game seven against the Mavericks. So it's literally the seventh seed from the West versus the one seed in the East in a game seven in the NBA Finals. One seed Celtics are up five with the ball. Tatum passes out. White, 9 seconds on the shot clock, 1:30 to go. Gets the screen for three. He missed it. Oh, offensive rebound for Cornette and he puts it in. 7 point game. Celtics lead. Luka Doncic is crazy. Raising the Luka Magic here. If they want to win this. Out to Green. Passes it to Washington. Washington driving. Stolen by Horford. White has the ball. 1 minute to go. Doesn't look good for the Mavs. White drives. Cornette puts it up. And it's in. It's a 9 point game. Luka, I don't even think Luka. This does not look good. Never mind. 7 point game.
Keep getting their shots swatted away by this squad.
And so White
has the ball.
Bring it up for the Boston Celtics. They led by as many as 18 points. Porzingis with a screen
White.
On Doncic.
Wide open. He drives. Goes back out. Oh, behind the back pass to Cornette. Cornette out to White again. 5 seconds on the shot clock. He gets the screen. White for three. He hit it. It's a 10-point game. 30 seconds. Hits is over. Luka can't even do anything. He needs to hit three threes and have himself a touch short ball. Put it up. He hit it. Of course, Luka hits it.
Doncic has got 41.
They're not fouling.
7 point differential.
It's over. The Celtics are going to win this. So we now know that if the playoffs started right now at the All-Star break, the Celtics would come out just edging out the Mavs in a game seven. This is crazy. I can't even believe the Mavs got here. Luka Doncic probably deserves finals MVP, even though his team didn't win. I mean, that was crazy. That was absolutely amazing.
The emotion, the exhaustion, culminating into tonight.
And whenever you win the NBA championship, there is a level of excitement.
So now, get the trophy, and the Celtics are going to lift it high.
But pretty amazing to have accomplished this goal.
We now have to see who wins finals.
The celebration is here, and this place is going crazy. The bench loves it. The fans obviously overjoyed. This is one of those moments these players
So the Celtics win their first championship since 2008.
Let's go to the floor. Here is Adam Silver presenting the Larry O'Brien
trophy. White, that's his crazy three. All right, let's see who won. Tatum scored 39, Brown 22, Holiday 13, Zingo 13, White 11, Hauser 10, Pritchard 9, Cornette 8, Horford 3, Tillman, 2. O'Shea Brissett didn't play. Gafford scored 2. Jones scored 4. 6 for Dante Exum. 9 for Josh Green. 10 for Derek Lively. 13 for Hardaway. 16 for Washington. 23 for Kyrie. And 41 for Luka. Now we need to see who won finals on the team. Oh my God. I was right. I actually called it. How did I call that? Wait, what? But I swear I didn't look, like, there's no way to look ahead and then go back and go, what? and I'm not like I'm doing the voice recording at the time I'm seeing this. What? I'm not overriding him, but like, how many minutes did he play? Doesn't say. He just did so well. Okay, well, I'll see you guys in the next one.